Love and anxiety. Love is natural and spontaneous. It springs forth from deep within, while anxiety is born in mind. Love and anxiety cannot exist together. And remember that only love brings a state of no anxiety, no mind. Everything else creates a new anxiety as you traverse through the life's roads. You can go on changing your anxieties. Somebody is seeking money, somebody is seeking power, then somebody starts seeking God. But always there is some kind of seeking, and this creates anxiety. Because things happen on its own, and you want to have the things acquired according to your own mind. Certainly, all things will bring anxiety. Every desire brings anxiety as a shadow to it. Anxiety comes to you as the shadow of desire. When there is a desire and it is taking longer to fulfill, anxiety comes in as a shadow. Every desire brings anxiety as a shadow to it. You can go on changing your anxieties. Somebody is seeking money. Someone else is seeking power. Then somebody starts seeking God. In one way or the other, everyone is seeking. Certainly, all these things bring anxiety. Every desire brings anxiety as a shadow to you. Anxiety comes into existence as the shadow of desire. When there is a desire, it is not fulfilling or it is taking long, then anxiety breeds it. And no desire can exist without anxiety. And anxiety is hell, anxiety is destructive, because anxiety creates a split in you and you are torn apart. You are not one piece, not together and not integrated. Only love integrates you. Love harmonizes you. Jesus says God is love, and I say love is God. It is not enough to say that God is love, because God may be more things than love. It may be love plus many other things. I say that love is God. Love is all and all. Nothing else is needed. That is why there are so much longing for love. One wants to love, one wants to be loved, because only in love you are in tune with existence. And when you are in tune, there is no anxiety. When you are out of tune, there is anxiety, there is chaos. Anxiety is symptomatic that somewhere you are not moving with the whole. Instead, you are moving alone. You are moving separate from the whole, maybe diametrically opposite to the whole, but you are moving away and in opposite direction to the whole. When you are separate, you are in difficulty, because the whole cannot be with you. Only you can go with the whole. Love gives you the first lesson in how to relax, how to trust, how to accept. Love gives you the first lesson in dropping the ego. When you love a person, you forget yourself. That very forgetfulness is the basis of all the religions. And in fact, when you forget yourself, you have forgotten the ego. Once you are in love, you know who you are. Once you are in love, you are in a deep contentment, and then delight arises, and your lover becomes a victim. love never ends. Love never ends with the lover. The lover is just the beginning of the love. And once love springs forth, then it goes on spreading. It is a reservoir that never finishes. And once love springs forth, it goes on spreading far and wide. When you are in love, you start loving all things. You cannot do otherwise. When you are in love, you love the moon, you love the trees, you love the river, you love everything. Suddenly you are so full of love that it goes on overflowing in everything that you do. Your gestures, your movements, your doings, everything start overflowing with love. When love overflows, it becomes a prayer. In love you are lost. In prayer the other is also lost. And a moment comes when there is no lover and no beloved. Only love and achievements. But this is state, when the lover and the beloved disappear, you have not experienced. When the problem begins along the path of love, you abandon it. And if you persist and continue along the path, a moment comes when there is no lover and no beloved, only love energy. That energy is delight, and in that energy there is no anxiety, that is bliss. That is the ultimate flowering of the being. Remember every moment. Life presents many situations, problems and circumstances. Confusions and despairs remain your way of life in every situation and circumstance. Out of your ignorance you go on overlooking or avoiding when the moments comes that can lead you to the state of inner bliss. This is the state of unconscious living and understanding. You do not trust the existence. You are part of it, yet you do not trust it. Remember, every circumstance and situation has great treasures hidden deep within. Your trust, awareness and meditation, by going deep within the situation, will unearth many treasures or gems. Each time you dive deep within the inner depths, you will discover new treasures. Your being is an unfathomable ocean. It has many gems and precious moments of understanding hidden. When you go deep within these moments, myriad gems will unravel their secrets to you as understanding and awareness. But man is unconscious. Although he believes he is conscious, that very belief keeps the ignorance intact. Man is just opposite of what he thinks he is. To understand this is the beginning of great revolution. This is dropping idealism, all anxiety, and begin a new journey of exploring gems from the ocean of being. Go, and then one day you will discover that you have remained only with love energy. That energy is delight, and there is no anxiety.